This video is brought to you by PantherGaming.com. Check the link in the description below. Use late night, no spaces, as your promo code to get 10% off of any order. And ultimately, I hope you guys enjoy the video. It's the Monday after Christmas. I guess that means it's time for a Q&A. So now that things have finally calmed down, the holidays are over, at least until New Year's Eve, I thought that we might as well get this Q&A out and we should return back to our usual schedule. So if you guys don't know what the Q&A is, all you have to do is leave your Halo-related questions in the comment section below and they may be answered on next week's show. So let's kick this week off with a question from 117Tempest, who says, Q&A, what do you think of the anniversary soundtracks for Halo CE and Halo 2? Personally, I thought Halo 2 Anniversary soundtrack in particular, CEA was a hit or miss for me, did a great job of updating the original music. I even think that it surpasses Marty's already great work in some instances. One example of this is the increased emphasis on vocals in the song Trapped in Amber, which I thought were just plain beautiful. So I actually agree with you, although I really like Halo CE Anniversary soundtrack. I like it a lot. It's not very ambitious or different, like it doesn't try to do anything unique. It really just tries to stick as close to the original vision as possible. And yeah, it does miss in a few areas, but for the most part, I do like the original anniversary soundtrack quite a lot. But Halo 2 anniversary soundtrack, I really like. There are a few instances where I'm like, I don't think you guys are getting the point of the original song, but like, it's okay, it's okay. This is also beautiful. But yeah, for the most part, I really like the anniversary soundtracks. And I also do think with Halo 2 Anniversary, we got some great original new music. Like, since the license for Breaking Benjamin's song ran out in Halo 2, they had to compose a new song, Breaking the Covenant, I think it was called, Breaking of the Covenant. That song is beautiful. It's incredible. I love it so much. And then I also really, really, really like the Reclaimer remix that they did in Halo 2 Anniversary, the one that plays in the Arbiter mission. It's just, Halo 2 Anniversary has a lot of beautiful music, and I really, really like the Anniversary soundtracks. So we're going to move on to a question from, actually, I've actually gotten this from a lot of people, but so I Love Food 246 asks, Halo Q&A, now that Josh Holmes has left 343, what direction do you think the Halo series will take, and if Halo 6 development has changed? So right now, I am doing as much research as I can on pretty much everything that Josh Holmes has done in terms of decision-making, in terms of, like, where he wants the series to go prior to him leaving 343, just so I can create a video that is well-informed and it's not just me babbling about things that I don't understand. But Josh Holmes, I do understand he did a lot of things that some people could argue were controversial. Like, I know that for Halo 4, he really pushed to have the Cortana narrative in it. He really pushed to have Cortana dying in Halo 4 and have it kind of like a story about Master Chief losing probably the closest friend he's ever had in his life. You know, but that being said, there were also some other not so great decisions like the Halo 4 multiplayer. Ultimately, I don't like to comment on individual people at 343 anymore because, like, it's not a single person there. Like, 343 is not a single entity. Decisions made there are made by an entire team of people, like multiple people, and sometimes hundreds of people. So it's kind of, I don't really like to just say, oh, it's this one person's fault, because it's really not. Like, it goes a lot deeper than that. But, you know, wherever Josh Holmes goes, I know that he wants to start making indie games now, and, you know, I wish him well, and I hope that his indie games turn out really well. So we're going to move on to a question from Christian Kim, who says, Q&A, do you think that in Halo 6, Warzone should be completely redone? By removing the rec system, it would already become better. One thing that they could do is put in some more interesting objectives. For example, say the team that is losing is Blue Team. And halfway through the match, Blue Team gets a chance to destroy a Forerunner core that the Red Team is supposed to protect, which would earn the Blue Team 200 points. There would be a large energy shield that covers the perimeter of the core, And then you had to enter the core and damage it so that blue team couldn't just snipe it. Another example would be that the team has maybe two bases, with the middle base held would have to fend off Covenant waves and bosses. I hope that this makes it into the Q&A. So I think that there were some typos in there, unless I misread, but it's perfectly all right. So yeah, in my opinion, there are a lot of issues with Warzone. I like the mode though. I like it. I like the ideas in it, and I hope that it returns in Halo 6, but a lot more refined. But some things that do need to either go or be brought just back to the drawing board, in my opinion, are the rec system and the bosses. So the bosses, I think, are a good idea. Just the issue is, a challenging boss is not one that can kill you instantly with a homing shot that you can't dodge and has a lot of health. Like, that's not challenging. That's just kind of frustrating and annoying because there's no plausible way to dodge it. Like, something that's challenging isn't me hiding behind a rock and unloading 360 SMG bullets into it and not even draining a quarter of its health. Like, that's not challenging. That's just going to waste my time, and it's not going to be fun, me shooting at a single target for 5 minutes until it dies. I do think that the bosses need to be brought back to the drawing board. I do think that more focus needs to be put on the AI. And not as in, like, well, we need more enemies. It's like, no. I mean the artificial intelligence. Like, they can't just stand there. You have to make them a little bit more clever. Because right now, Halo 5, the AI in that game isn't particularly good. Like, it's not very good. It's very obvious that there were some downgrades, some cutbacks when it comes to the AI. Like, I noticed it in Halo 4 that the Covenant, they weren't quite as smart as they used to be in previous Halo games. And it was really obvious in Halo 5 when there are so many of them and they're just standing there, or they're programmed to move to a specific position. So they are literally just throwing themselves into gunfire in order to make it to the position that they were programmed to get to. Like, they have no sense of self-preservation. So when it comes to the AI, I do think that they need to be reworked and upgraded. They can't be so dumb, because when the AI are dumb, really the only next best thing that you can do is to, well, I guess give them a lot of health, and we gotta make them challenging somehow, so I guess give them homing shots? And, well, if there's going to be, like, a team of 12 Spartans fighting this thing, it's gotta do a lot of damage, right? So I guess make the homing shots insta-kill? And then there you go. Now you've got a problem. You've got a boring boss that takes a lot of damage, and it's cheap to kill because if it so much as sees you, you're dead instantly. So it's ultimately very frustrating to deal with. I also do think the rec system needs to be taken back to the drawing board, because there are a couple of issues that I have with it, mainly, like, why is the storm rifle there? Like, why do I need to spend one rec point, which takes about 30 minutes, or 30 minutes, Christ, no, 30 seconds to kind of charge up, you know, when I could just keep all my rec points on standby so that I could get myself a sniper rifle later. Like, there are certain things that you will avoid buying because it's just like, why? Like, that thing is so useless. Why is it even there? Like, the storm rifle, you know, why should I have to pay for the storm rifle? And it's just like, there are a lot of issues there. That being said, I do really like the idea of spawning with different weapon variants. I do really like a lot of the ideas that Warzone presents. And I really think, like, what's kind of interesting is Warzone, if they want to expand on it, it could be one of the most impressive big team battle kind of. I'm just thinking of, you know, those, like, large scale shooters like Battlefield. Like, Halo could get up there with Battlefield if they really wanted to push the Warzone agenda. Halo's sandbox, its vehicle to on-foot sandbox, is really strong, and I think, especially right now, a lot of Halo fans, they don't really realize it when they sit, but if you sit back and think, like, not many shooters nowadays on the market can boast on-foot and vehicle combat with it, like, so seamlessly, like Halo does it. Like, even Battlefield, the transition between on-foot and vehicle combat, it's very janky. Like, with Battlefield 4, you just go up to a vehicle, and then it's like, boom! like you instantly teleport into the cockpit of the jet or whatever, like no transitional period. And then with Battlefield 1, there's kind of like this janky, laggy animation that plays that is kind of glitchy. Sometimes the camera wonks out depending on the net code. And it, like, Halo, everything is so seamless. It all feels so seamless and smooth, the transition. And I think that if 343 were really to capitalize on it, Warzone could become this impressive thing. And so, sadly, now we're stuck with kind of like this awkward transitional phase when it comes to Halo 5, where it's like, Halo 5 is experimenting with some interesting ideas. Let's see if they refine those ideas in the future. So moving on, we're going to answer a question from EV, who says, Q&A, love what you're doing. I think it's really helping the community. Sorry to be vague and open on my question, but what would your ideal Halo 6 look like? Specifically, what type of campaign, what type of gameplay, and what type of art style do you want? Do you want a classic Halo campaign making the player feel like part of an epic world, or a Halo 4 campaign style with a focus on the characters? What new mechanics do you think should stay or be removed? Hope this makes it and keep up the good work. So I would definitely disagree that I'm helping the community. A lot of people would argue that I'm ruining it. But ultimately, what I'm just trying to do is, like, just open up discussions. Just get people talking. Like, if it does help the community, then great. But, like, you know, I'm not going to call myself the savior of Halo. Because I'm not. I'm just a person with ideas. And I want to listen to other people's ideas. But, so, when it comes to my ideal Halo 6, preferably, now look. In a perfect world, what I would like is I would like something Halo 3-esque where it's all about the scope and the scale of the levels. Like, they're big, they're expansive, there's clever AI, there's beautiful music, lots of fun weapons and a fun vehicle sandbox. I would like the Halo 3 art style, like the Halo 3 music, the gameplay. I would like it to go back to the Halo 3 style of gameplay with equipment, no sprinting. Like, that would be my perfect world for Halo. Overall, I do feel that, like, definitely with Halo 5, but they're like missing the kind of sandboxy openness of the levels. Like, Halo 5 has some of the most linear levels in the entire series. And the thing is, like, even though some levels do have really big environments in some areas, I'm thinking of Blue Team, the point where you take the elevator down to, like, that open outdoor, like, in outer space sequence where there's, like, the Banshees flying around and stuff. Like, that is a pretty big environment, but when you're on foot, there's not a lot of areas you can go to. A majority of that open space is just open space with, like, a few catwalks so you can walk around. And honestly, it's just, like, the objectives are really just destroy these things. And, like, you know, a Phantom will kind of, like, lazily come in and drop off some troops and then just kind of, like, I don't know, bump into a Banshee or something as it, like, clumsily flies back out into outer space and then despawns where you can see it. Like, it's really janky and kind of awkward and stuff. And I think also another thing is that, like, a lot of these open rooms in Halo 5, they feel much smaller because you have, like, four people. You have three other Spartans with you. So it's, like, it ends up feeling a lot smaller than it actually is. And then, of course, you do have some environments where it legit is as small as it feels. Like, I'm thinking of a lot of the Meridian levels, some of the Genesis levels, where it's just like, wow, this is so linear. Like, Halo isn't known for having levels that are this linear. Like, even Halo 4, which was the more linear of the series, even Halo 4 had some bigger environments than this. And it's just, it's very frustrating that, like, they're kind of losing track of that. I think that what really needs to happen is there needs to be a focus on two different styles of play. So when you're inside, that's when the levels can be linear because, I mean, you're in a building, you're in a construct. Of course it's linear. There are literal hallways. But when you're outside, when I'm outside in Halo, I shouldn't feel like I'm still in a hallway, just this time the walls are invisible. Like, when you're outside in Halo, the environment should be big. They should be expansive, massive, sprawling. You should feel like, wow, I'm outside. I'm not in a first-person shooter level. And sadly, that's just something that I think that Halo is losing track of. But, you know, I hope that that answers your question. So we are going to finish this off with a question from Michael Lee, who says, Q&A. Hey, LNG, what do you think of a Halo movie? Now, I know that video game movies always seem like failures, but movies based on books aren't. And it just so happens that there are some books in the Halo series. So what do you think of a movie that is based only on the books, i.e. The Fall of Reach, and not the games? Love this channel, and thanks for reading this. Well, thank you. So, you bring up a very good point. Now, the thing is, when it comes to video games are very difficult to make into movies, primarily because there's just a lot of stupid things in video games that, when you translate them to the big screen, it's like, oh man, yeah, that really is a video game. Now, the reason that books work a lot better when they're translated into movies, well, when they're translated well into movies, is because, well, like, they're essentially the same thing. The only difference is, with a book, you're not seeing what's going on. With a movie, you are. Like, they are the same style of narrative, where you're telling a three-act story. Where with video games, you've got to change things up, you got to include gameplay elements, you've got to kind of have padding within the story to make up for long levels where the player can just, like, do whatever they want. So it's like, oh god, okay, so we gotta figure out how to stretch out the story for a single level so the player can just, like, have fun. So when it comes to Halo, I actually do think you bring up a very good point that maybe the solution is taking one of Halo's novels and turning that into a movie. Something I've actually thought about in the past is maybe as some kind of mini series, like some kind of like five-parter, each part is like an hour or an hour and a half long. Take the Forerunner trilogy, turn that into a mini series. Like, that could work if they wanted it to, because the Forerunner trilogy is pretty damn cool, if you ask me. I have all the books, I really like them. The first book in the series is probably one of my favorite science fiction novels I've ever read, but, you know, those are just like my thoughts and stuff. Now, it's actually cool because I do games from time to time with Wyvern Zoo, if you guys know who she is. She's the one who is bringing Invasion back to Halo 5. She's also working on a few remixes of maps from Halo Reach for her Invasion game mode. And when we were forging together, she actually said that probably what could work if you wanted to is make some kind of Suicide Squad-esque movie, where instead of just having Master Chief as the main character, because honestly, in a movie, he wouldn't be strong enough as a main character to carry the narrative on his shoulders. So maybe what they could do is have some kind of Suicide Squad-esque movie where Chief is one of many main characters. Have like a grunt, have like an elite, have like a, you know, wacky, scared Marine, have like a confident ODST, and maybe have like this story of this group of people where it's like, oh, there's like that weird guy who was like turned into a cyborg robot killing machine when he was a child. You've got this weird alien that is small and squeaky. You got this weird alien that's like tall and scary. Like, just something like that where it's like a group of people on a journey and none of them really get along and, you know, just something like that. And I thought that that was a really cool idea. Yeah. And so, guys, that wraps it up for this week. So thank you all so much for asking your questions. I'm sorry if I wasn't able to get to any other questions. If you check my Twitter, you can actually ask me questions there, and I'll try to answer them as best as I can. Remember to leave a like, comment, you know, share the videos around, because currently YouTube is screwing over a lot of people because they changed the search algorithms on YouTube without letting anyone know. So it's screwing a lot of people over, and ultimately, guys, I hope you enjoyed and have a good Monday.